such an unpleasant way to go. I have to wonder how the group will fare without their leader. It can be difficult working with someone you've been involved with, but I think Mark and Kate may be finding a way and learning some new things about each other. And how do we feel about Mr. Dumet's lovely animatronics? I think they're rather clever. Some of them look very realistic. I wonder where he sources the parts. It would only be fair at this stage to offer up a little hint to even the odds. What do you think? Let's take some inspiration from the works of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Apparently, our friend Herman Mudgett was so enamored with Sherlock Holmes that he borrowed his surname. Here. He has a brain of the first order. He sits motionless like a spider in the center of its web. But that web has 1,000 radiations, and he knows well every quiver of each of them. I hope that helps. You'd better get back to things. Best of luck.
I could have saved him.
Aaron, no way.
Damn it.
It's another trap.
It's the only way out of here. So we're going to find out.
Is this a good idea?
I don't see any other options. Where the hell are we?
Columbus Spa.
This is Laura at reception.
What the hell?
The Columbus Spa is now open for guests. We treat each and every one of our guests like a real work of art.
Son of a bitch. He's watching us.
Keep looking around.
Worth a try?
I'll see if I can get this open. You guys keep looking for another way out.
Can all visitors get a couple of weeks?
Mark, give me a hand. I think we can bust through this thing.
3, 2, 1, go! Kate?
What happened?
We'll get back to you. Stay there.
Just hurry! Oh, that hurt.
What? This wasn't in the script.
Stay close.
Obviously. What the fuck just happened?
Keep looking around.
No point just standing around. Mark, give me a hand moving this shit.
Huh. Mark, here. Let's move the desk.
Hello? Mark? Jamie?
Here.
Kate.
We're okay.
We're okay.
Thank God. We found a key. Let's get out of here. Hear that? This way.
Kate! locked.
Shit. What was that? I can't breathe.
These windows are welded in place. He fucking wants us to watch. Wait, look. Regulator switch.
Will that give them air?
No. Not both of them.
It's sucking out all the air.
Whoever we point this lever at is gonna die.
What?
Something!
He wants to choose, doesn't he? Oh my god.
I can't.
If we don't do something, both of them will die, Mark.
Jamie!
To choose now. No,
we had to do something. They were both gonna die.
Thank you. Thank you.
No, Kate.
Window.
There's a leak.
Back up.
A game, and it's no fucking joke. You okay?
Just leave me alone.
Look, we have to get smart about this before one of us ends up dead like Charlie.
Wait, Charlie's dead?
Dumet got him and forced us to play some game. We had to watch him die.
We need a plan. Forget his games, traps, all that bullshit. Think about the killers we've covered. There's always a weakness.
You suggesting we invite him to tea and psychoanalyze?
I'm suggesting we use our heads.
We can make guesses all day, but if we die here, it won't matter. I'm not playing detective, I just want to survive.
Playing detective is how we survive. We play his games, we'll lose. We need to outthink him.
He's trying to pick us off one at a time. We need to stick together.
Hang on. Back to the ferry.
It left, remember?
It's on a line. Maybe we could reel it in.
Maybe isn't good enough.
The lighthouse. Maybe we can signal for help. There's police boats patrolling the lakes, right?
All the way out here?
Lighthouses are meant to be seen for miles.
He's probably got it rigged with traps.
Then we gotta be really fucking careful. It's our best shot.
Are you shooting any of us? No one is gonna believe it without proof.
You want me to record him trying to kill us?
And the bodies? For the cops.
Hear that? The walls are moving again.
Kate, hang on. We need to stay close.
Shit! Kate! Hang on!
fuck.
Thank you.
72.
Psychological assessment conducted by Dr. Isabella Garcia. Patient name, Monday, Hector. Behavioral observation. Hector arrived at our scheduled appointment 24 minutes late. Once we sat down and began the session, he struggled to maintain eye contact. He found it difficult to articulate his feelings and was terse and guarded throughout. Hector has been working long hours and, as a result, isn't sleeping well. Hector spoke about his recently deceased mother and displayed evidence that he hasn't yet fully come to terms with her death. I strongly recommended a course of antidepressants, but he is resistant to this idea, believing that it would have a detrimental effect on his capability with regards to his current investigation. Hector describes his work in immaculate detail, and contrary to earlier in the session, his thought content is both coherent and logical. He is displaying an unhealthy obsession with his work, but his recent bereavement may be the underlying issue.
Here for your amusement. So now what? Here we go. Oh, what the hell?
want to know what it means to be a killer. You ever been to the art museum downtown? They got this painting by a guy, I forget his name, famous painter. He did portraits of slaughtered cows hanging on hooks. You take a normal person to a slaughterhouse, and they will puke their guts out. You make it into a painting, and suddenly it's art. There's no difference between the two. Not really. Don't look at me like that. You know I'm right. You get it. I know you get it. You got to do something that matters. Make people feel something they've never felt before. Shatter the illusion that any of us are really in control. Think of the most profound thing you've ever done. The most beautiful thing you've ever created. And I promise you, it's nothing compared to watching the life bleed out of someone. To see the fear in their eyes. To feel them pawing at you for release. To hear them pleading. Begging. That moment when someone realizes they are at their end. That's when you feel it. That's true art. That's what you have to be. An artist. A sculptor. An architect. I see the gleam in your eye, Agent Monday. You're not fooling me. Look! Oh, look at you now, huh? Am I gonna be your first? Well, come on then, huh? I'm right here. This room is soundproof. You don't even have to wait for a plane to fly overhead. There you are. I see you now. Oh, not bad. Not bad at all. Bare hands can feel good, huh? But the blade makes for such a prettier picture. You've got potential, Agent Monday. If you truly want to be an artist.
Stay close to me. Thank you.
who says self-help books don't work.
Charlie threw it down here earlier.
Of course he did.
Jamie.
Wait, hey, look at this.
What?
It's a true crime book. Look at the author, Joseph Morello. So the guy on the ferry wasn't Dumet.
Through here.
Bethany, was that in the sign-in book?
Shit! It's me! Get in here!
Jamie?
Thank God. What the hell is this? Pleased to see you too, Kate. Glad you're alive. Listen, I found out some new information.
What?
That guy on the ferry? That was not Dumet. That was Joseph Morello. He's a true crime writer. I found one of his books.
How's he wrapped up in this?
I don't know. Have you seen Mark?
No. I've seen Dumet, though. He's creeping around. Jesus.
What is all of this?
He's got video feeds, recording decks, a mixer big enough for countless mics.
He's watching everything.
It's more than that. He's got utilities running through here, hydraulics, electrics, everything.
It's like a nerve center for the whole building.
It's a director's suite.
Maybe we could use it to find a way out. Look for something to unlock the outer doors.
This all connects. This is how he's getting around the house.
This is a lot. This is top end gear. I mean, I know he's rich, but you could launch a rocket.
Take a look at this. What is that?
The guy we saw murdered.
It was a setup?
There was no groundskeeper.
Why would he do that?
To scare us. To get us in the mood for his fun and games.
Nice. Charlie would say this guy is a fractured psyche. That he's wearing a mask to put what he's doing on a different personality.
That's probably just his theory, because he can't reconcile a human doing this stuff. Been tracking us since we arrived. Mark was last seen in the basement.
What do you think it is?
I think it's a mistake to say he's just crazy. He is in full control of what he's doing. He's just not wired like the rest of us.
What's the difference?
Crazy implies out of control. Look at this place. This is methodical. That's not crazy.
Chicago Police, Mr. Monday, this is Chicago Police. Can you open the door, please? Mr. Monday, I'm Officer Stanley with Chicago Police Department. Can you hear me, sir? Agent Monday. Fuck. Oh. Dispatch, this is Officer Stanley. I need assistance at 8 West 50th Street, requesting immediate backup. I'm in Agent Monday's apartment. There's blood everywhere, and a body. I need immediate support. I think...
Wait, he's wearing the mask as part of the performance. At best, maybe he's insecure about something and it gives him confidence.
Insecure? Like, low self-esteem? Is he uncomfortable at parties? Did his mommy not hug him enough?
Bad parenting can definitely be a factor, but
It could be a shitty dad just as much, or an uncle, any adult figure, really. Don't you read any of our research?
I just set up the lights.
I'm sure he fits the profile. Bullied as a kid, unchecked anger. As an adult, he's either an extreme overachiever or a cipher. Nothing between. He likes being in a position of power, especially over women.
But why this? Why us?
Aside from the unhealthy obsession with H.H. Holmes, he's copying the M.O. Clearly, he identifies with Holmes somehow.
How did he build all this?
This is everything about me. Jesus. Can we use this gear to find a way out? Maybe we can open those shutters in the lobby. What is this?
Hi, Mr. Monday. This is Lucinda Price from Twilight Prairie Care Home. I've tried to call you a couple of times. I understand that you're making voice recordings of your mother, and we do believe that this morning relative is
dead. Over here!
Look at this. It's all his little tricks of moving walls and crap.
Nothing in this shit box is real. He controls everything from here. It's a murder factory.
You're right. We should use this against him.
All right. What's your plan?
Okay, look. He's in here, right? So we get him to go down this hall, and we trap him between these two moving walls. There's no other way out of there. He'd be stuck.
So, how do we get him to go down that hall?
One of us is going to have
to be bait.
No, no way. It's too risky, Jamie.
So is letting him run free. I'd say that's more dangerous. Come on.
No, no, no way. If something goes wrong, one of us will be dead.
Yeah, I'm not super into doing it, but I am done being scared of what's around every corner.
There's no second chances here.
Who's gonna do it?
It's my plan. I'll be the bait.
You're joking.
No. One of us has to.
If you're sure, just... If it looks like it's going south, get the hell out of there.
No argument here.
You could use that as a weapon if need be.
I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm more likely to need it. Okay. That's enough of a moment. Let's do this.
Stick to the plan.
Obviously.
So how do we get out?
Third floor must be a work in progress. Okay, be ready. You're gonna have to time it right to trap him and not me.
Jamie, don't do anything stupid. If you see him, please just run. You have to come back, okay?
Copy that. All right. Here goes nothing. Head down the hall, keep to the right. Was this on the map? More rooms being built. Thank you. fucking run! Oh, God. There's a reverse symbol on it.
What does it?
No! I can't do this. I won't kill you.
Excruciating way to go. Jamie wouldn't press the button. She chose to spare Kate at the cost of her own life. Admirable. People can surprise you sometimes. Did the hint I gave you earlier help? Perhaps you'd like another. Let's see if Sir Arthur can help us. This is from The Man with the Twisted Lip. Have you read it? You should. A trusty comrade is always of use, and a chronicler still more so. I think that last bit might refer to me. You should get back. I hope these chats are helpful. I certainly wouldn't want them to be intimidating. I'll be watching your progress, as always, watching very closely.
Come on.
owe you. Come on. Aaron!
What happened to you guys?
We're both alive. That's all that matters.
Is he gone?
Thank you.
Stay away from me. Take back all the times I called you bitch face. You're my fucking hero, Kate.
I figured if I let you die, you'd haunt me.
You're not wrong.
You okay?
Yeah, I think so.
Fuck yes. Suck it, Demet. Holy shit.
Rot in hell, asshole!